Welcome, folks, to another game of Smash Brothers here with the Springfield Wildcats versus the Gamble Montessori School Gators. We're here for week three for Super Smash Brothers. First up, we have Christopher Lester for the Springfield Wildcats going to pick on the first player for the Gators. Now, how this gameplay goes for Smash Brothers is that it's a crew battle, not based on 1v1 or who takes out who first, but more based on lives. Each player has 3 lives, so each team needs to pick out a total of 15 lives. Here we go. We have Christopher Lester as Toon Link going up against Mario. Here we go with our first game. 3, 2, 1, go! All right, folks, that was a good game against Chris Arts here for the Springfield Wildcats against the Gamble High School Gator. Chris was able to knock down that Mario clean with only one life left. Unfortunately, with one life left, he heads on to the second player for Gamble. Now, for the next game, it's a little unusual because Gamble, second player, is facing off against Chris, who will start the match with only one life. So that's where Crew Brothers go. If they move on to the next round, Chris starts the next round with his lives that he had from the first game, but starts over at 0%. So we'll see how this next game goes. Stay tuned, and we'll get the game two going. All right, next up we have Dominik Jaimez for the Springfield Wildcats up against the Gamble High School Gator that went up against Chris just a little bit ago. Chris was able to get the Gator up to 94%, but unfortunately was taken out. It's okay. He took out the Gator in the first game, so it's a Dominik 3 lives versus 3 lives. Dominik usually picks the Little Mac. He's very effective against Little Mac, so we'll see how this game plays.
Three, two, one, go! There! back.
And Dominik was able to take out the Gamble player. But Dominik only has one life left to take on the third player from Gamble. We'll see what happens. Dominik is going to stay with Little Mac. And we'll just see what Gamble has to play for the third game. Right now they're doing the banning of maps right now between each player, the losing player that just lost, and Dominik. Picking the maps, and then picking the player as well. So stay tuned for match three, and we'll get the game going.
Choose your fighter. Thomas. Choose your fighter.
All right, folks, sorry for the wait. We got Brandon Russell for the Springfield Wildcats going up against Gamble's K. Rule. Brandon is a new player for the Smash Brothers this season. We'd like to thank Brandon for joining our team and contributing. Hopefully he can stand up to this K. Rule and just knock him out. We'll see what happens. Sorry, folks, it took a while. Banning the maps right now, trying to pick the map. Looks like Small Battlefield is the map that they want to play on. As a head count, if you're just joining us right now, Gamble and Springfield are tied with 9 lives each. And we're playing a crew battle mode, which means it's not based on 1v1 knocking each other out with how many with surviving. It's about how many lives they can take out altogether. So if Brandon can knock out the K-Roll with his 3 lives left, fantastic. That's the perfect scenario we want. But if he has 2 lives left, 1 life left, he follows through. So here we go with game 3. Samus versus King K.
2, 1, go!
Your fighter, Young Link.
All right, guys, we're up for our fourth player for the Springfield Wildcats, Nathan Swartz. He is playing as young Link, going up against the Gamble K-Rule. The K-Rule was able to knock out two Springfield players. Springfield is down to two players. Gamble is down to three players. Score is 9 lives to 6 lives. Gamble is in the lead. Here we go for game, for the next game. Stay tuned, folks.
Three, two, one, go!
Choose your fighter.
Three, two, one.